Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to Young Family in our YouTube channel. Today is October 24th, 2021. In today's video, first I'm going to introduce my new collection of rose plants. Then I'm going to tell you a little bit how I got these new plants for free. Stay tuned. Here I have three rose plants. They are planted in three small containers. They are pretty much the same. Actually, I got them from similar mother rose plants. First, let's take a look at the leaves. As you can see here, all the leaves color is light green, glossy foliage. All these leaves is a perfect backdrop for white flowers. Then let's take a look at the flowers. Actually, these rose plants produce pure white flowers. But to be honest, most of flowers is pure white, but you still can find some light pink color on the flowers. So let's check out this one, and you can see more clearly. This is one flower bud. You can see here, it's kind of a little bit light pink on it. And there is another flower just began to open. You can see inside a little bit pink color. One of the most attractive features for these rose plants, it can form many flowers at the same time. It can form blooms in clusters up to 15 flowers per spray. All these pure white flowers are fragrant with mild honey fragrance. These rose plants can bloom from middle spring to middle fall. These rose plants can grow up to 4 to 5 feet high and wide. For best growth and blooms, they prefer full sun. All these rose plants are very easy to grow, carefree, grow vigorously, with upright stems. Even though all these rose plants are called naturally disease resistant, if you don't take good care of them, you still can find some mold and mildew on the leaves and the stems, especially for those rose plants are grow very crowded without very good airflow. You might be wondering, what's the name for these rose plants? Actually, based on my observation and search online, the botanical name for this rose plant is Rosa Hybrid Iceberg. All these features make this rose plant one of the best white rose plant for landscape and garden. Based on website, this rose plant is an international bestseller. Actually, it is pretty common and popular in our Southern California. I can always find these rose plants everywhere. Many people like to grow these rose plants in their front yard. You can see many white flowers in clusters. I once went to the local Home Depot store, garden center. I found these rose plants with a similar size to this rose plant, but with more flower buds on it. They were asked for $20. Actually, it is not cheap. Then I'm going to tell you how I got these rose plants. Actually, I got all these rose plants for free. To be honest, I propagated all these rose plants using air layering tactic. On June 24th, 2021, I air layered three rose branches from similar rose mother plants. During that time, all the rose plants in the rose garden were blooming. They produced many clusters of blooms. I once shot a YouTube short and post on my YouTube channel. You can check out. Now let's take a look at the plant label. Have a general idea about how I got the rose plant. This one I use Clone X Plus rooting hormone powder. I use peat moss as a rooting media. And check out this one. Let's come here. And I use Clone X and the powder. The same thing. I use root as a here. Check out peat moss as rooting media. And check out this one. I use Clone X and Homodin 3 and Cocoa Mix as a rooting media. So basically, this one and this one, I use the exact same way. And that one I use Cocoa Mix. This both I use peat moss. So as you can see here, all the plants are pretty healthy. Actually, on September 6, 2021, over 2 months after I air layered all these branches, I cut off and transplanted into all these three small containers. Then I just put it right here in the shade. You can see right here a lot of trees. So they are pretty healthy actually right now. They are blooming. Each plant has two or three flowers or flower buds. You can see what this one is fully open. And here there's one flower bud. For this one, you can see here there's one flower bud and another one flower bud. And a tiny one right here. You see here, it's right here. And for this one, I think two right here. There is one small rosebud, flower bud. And this one, it is almost open. So basically, you can see here, all these rose plants are pretty healthy. They are blooming right now. I'm very happy with them. Actually, I seldom take care of them. In the last part of this video, I'd like to talk about a little bit of concern about all these rose plants. Based on what I said in the beginning, all these rose plants are supposed to produce a lot of flower buds. But right now, you can see each plant, I just got two or three rose flowers. Why? So there's several reasons I'm thinking about why I cannot get more rose flowers. The first thing I'd like to talk about is watering. Actually, all these rose plants, I didn't water manually. I just use water irrigation system. As you can see here, there's a sprinkler up there. So actually, once per day, they automatically water all this grass and the plants. You can check out here. All the soil is pretty wet. You can see here, it's pretty wet. So I don't worry about the watering problem because all the rose plants, the leaves is pretty healthy. It's light green. The second thing I'm thinking about is the plant container. As you can see here, the plant container actually is pretty small. I think it's about 4 to 6 inches in diameter. It is pretty small and less than 1 gallon, maybe 0.6 gallon size. So for this rose plant, as I mentioned, it can grow 4 to 5 feet high and wide. So this container might be too small for all this rose plant because they grow very fast. So I think there might be a reason. The rose container, the pot, is too small. Another thing I once mentioned, the rose plants prefer full sun. Actually, starting from September 6th, I put all these rose plants in this shade, in this spot. I didn't remove them. As you can see here, all around have a lot of trees. Only in the morning from that area can receive some sunlight, just a couple of hours. I don't think it's enough for all these rose plants. So this might be another major reason for these rose plants cannot produce more flowers. The first reason I'm thinking about is fertilizers. Actually, starting from September 6th to today, today is October 24th, I seldom take care of them. I didn't apply any fertilizers on these rose plants. Actually, you know, the rose plants prefer some sort of fertilizers. So basically, I didn't apply any fertilizers, even though they grow very healthy. But I think fertilizer might be very, very helpful for these rose plants to produce more and beautiful flowers. For my flowering and fruiting plants, I always fully spray mono potassium phosphate. If I can apply MKP on these rose plants, I think they can produce more flowers. The last thing I'm thinking about is deadhead the flowers. At the beginning, I just cut off some old flowers. Then I didn't prune all these rose plants, as you can see here. Even though they grow robustly, you can see a lot of leaves, but actually not so many flower buds. So basically, I should prune or just trim all these rose plants to get more new branches, maybe new flowers, more flowers. Right now, I have 3 rose plants. I'm thinking about probably I can transplant 2 rose plants in the ground and still keep 1 in the container. Then later, probably I can trim the rose plants to form a rose tree. That would be very interesting. Okay, anyway, thank you so much for watching. See you next time.